President Duterte appears to slam the indemnity clause in the tripartite agreement for the country's COVID-19 vaccine deals. That's despite signing it into law just last month. It absolves private firms from any liability from the use of their COVID-19 vaccines and crucial in-government procurement deals for the jabs. But last night, the president rejected the idea and described it as illegal.
The government cannot guarantee, much less give you an immune status. Na you are freed of any and all liability. Masyadong mataas na. I think we cannot even do that, even if we wanted to. Yung assumption ng liability for these tax that are bought from the private sector. Sa kanila, hindi pwede. Ang gusto ng mga manufacturers na ang gobyerno, ang private sector magbili, ang gobyerno ang mag-assume ng liability. Hindi ho pwede yung ganun. It's illegal for us to do that.
1 million more doses of Sinovac's COVID-19 vaccine will arrive in the Philippines by March 29th. That's according to Manila's ambassador to China, Jose Santiago Santa Romana. Santa Romana says this is the first batch procured by the Philippine government, with more deliveries scheduled for the following months. This is on top of the 400,000 Sinovac doses donated by China, expected to arrive on March 24th. At least three Philippine senators want the country's interagency COVID task force, or the IATF, abolished or overhauled. Senate President Vicente Soto III and Senators Aimee Marcos and Risa Ontiveros are blaming the task force for failing to curb the spread of COVID-19 in the country.
They should have done that from day one, especially when we were already complaining around June that there is gross incompetence in the handling as far as the Department of Health is concerned on that particular issue. Ang problema kasi sa atin, no, pag hindi sa kanila galing ang idea, parang hindi nila gusto eh. Gusto nila galing sa kanila eh.
For Senator Ontiveros, the leaders of the task force should be replaced by health experts. Senator Marcos, meanwhile, suggests the creation of a new body to replace the IATF.
And at the end of the day, ang kalusugan ang siyang issue. Eh, expert sa kalusugan natin, syempre, doktor. Pagkatapos mga scientists, dapat science-based, obviously immunologists, none of which we have right now except for a single doctor who no one seems to trust anyway. So why don't we go back and establish a core group that is really qualified for policy, and thereafter start consulting the LGUs who, yung pala, ibabagsak din pala sa kanila yung trabaho para sa implementation, so we should bring them on. And it gets sa lahat yung private sector.
The number of new COVID-19 cases in the country reached a new record high on Monday at over 8,000. Health officials also confirmed the more contagious coronavirus variants are present in all the cities in Metro Manila. Malacañang again blaming its critics for all the negative press it's been getting on its pandemic response. During Monday night's address, President Rodrigo Duterte and his spokesperson Harry Roque accused critics of using the pandemic for their own political gains, with the 2022 national elections drawing near.
So kung meron pa pong konsyensyang natitira yung mga nais manalo, na desperadong manalo, eh sana po, eh tumulong na lang po sila magbigay ng solusyon dito sa problema nito kesa pinagsasamantalahan po ang pandemya para sa kanilang mga selfish political game.
That's what you would call the classic case of if you want to appear white, you paint the other guy black. Para ang labas mo, puting-puti ka. Si Mr. Clean, parang ganun. Ganun yan eh. Style Bulok.